This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The history of public transport authorities in London details the various organisations that have been responsible for the public transport network in and around London, England from 1933 until 2000 and have used the London Transport brand. Their responsibilities have encompassed the buses, coaches, trams and the London Underground. The period began with the creation of the London Passenger Transport Board, which covered the County of London and adjacent counties within a 30-mile 48 km radius. This area later came under the control of the London Transport Executive and then the London Transport Board. The area of responsibility was reduced to that of the Greater London Administrative Area in 1970 when the Greater London Council, and then London Regional Transport took over responsibility. Since 2000, the Greater London Authority has been the Transport Authority and the Executive Agency has been called Transport for London, ending the 67-year use of the London Transport name. Contents 1. Background 2. London's Transport Authorities 2.1.1.93.3.1.9.4.8, London Passenger Transport Board 2.2.1.9.4.8.1.9.6.3, London Transport Executive 2.3.1.9.6.3.1.9.7.0, London Transport Board 2.4.1.9.7.0.1.9.8.4, London Transport Executive 2.5.1.9.8.4.2000, London Regional Transport 26.2000 onwards, Transport for London 3. See also 4 references. 5 External links. Background: prior to 1933, the ownership and management of the transport system in London was distributed among a large number of independent and separate organisations. The Underground Railway system had been developed and was owned by the Underground Electric Railways Company of London (UERL) and the Metropolitan Railway Tram and Trolleybus Networks were owned by various local authorities and public companies, and buses were owned by numerous companies. Many of these services were in competition with one another, leading to wasteful duplication. The London County Council managed tram operations within the County of London, but its responsibility did not extend to the bus or tram routes that ran outside its area, or to the railways, which also extended into neighbouring counties. A Royal Commission on London Government in the 1920s did not permit the London County Council to extend its area of responsibility, and an ad hoc London traffic area was created to regulate motor traffic in the wider London region in the 1930s. Another ad hoc solution was sought to improve the control and coordination of public transport. London's Transport Authorities 1933-1948, London Passenger Transport Board, London Passenger Transport Area, County of London in Grey. Main article: London Passenger Transport Board. The London Passenger Transport Board LPTB was the transport authority from 1 July 1933 to 31 December 1947. It unified services in the London area for the first time. The London Passenger Transport Act 1933 removed responsibility for 16,717 miles, 26,903. 1948-1963, London Transport Executive. Main article: London Transport Executive. The London Transport Executive LTE was the transport authority from 1 January 1948 to 31 December 1962. London Transport was taken into public ownership and became part of the British Transport Commission, which brought London Transport and British Railways under the same control for the first and last time. The period saw the start of direct recruitment from the Caribbean and the repair and replacement of stock and stations damaged during the war, as well as completion of delayed projects such as the Central Line Eastern Extension. The Routemaster bus was introduced in 1956, trams were withdrawn in 1952, and trolleybuses in 1962-1963-1970. London Transport Board. Main article: London Transport Board. The London Transport Board was the transport authority from 1 January 1963 to 31 December 1969. It reported directly to the Minister of Transport, ending its direct association with the management of British Railways. During this period, many of Britain's unprofitable railways were closed down, as most routes in the capital were widely used. The Beeching Acts had little effect, however. During this period, there was little investment in public transport, and the motor car increased in popularity. During this period, the Victoria Line was opened, although Work had started in the early 1960s, and the AEC Merlin single-deck bus was introduced 1970-1984. London Transport Executive London Transport sign at Beacontree Heath main article. London Transport Executive GLC. The Greater London Council was the transport authority from 1 January 1970 to 28 June 1984, and the executive agency was called the London Transport Executive. The legislation creating the Greater London Council GLC was already passed in 1963 when the London Transport Board was created. However, control did not pass to the new authority until 1 January 1970. The GLC broadly controlled only those services within the boundaries of Greater London. The green painted country buses and green line coaches had been passed in 1969 to a new company, London Country Bus Services, which in 1970 became part of the National Bus Company. The period is perhaps the most controversial in London's transport history, and there was a severe lack of funding from central government and staff shortages. The intermodal zonal ticketing system currently used by Transport for London originated in this period following the Greater London Council election in 1981. The incoming Labour administration simplified fares in Greater London by introducing 4 new bus fare zones and 2 central London underground zones, named City and West End, where flat fares applied for the first time. This was accompanied by a cut in prices of about a third and was marketed as the Fares Fair campaign following successful legal action against it. On 21 March 1982, London buses fares were subsequently doubled and London Underground fares increased by 91%. The 2 central area zones were retained and the fares to all other stations were restructured to be graduated at 3-mile intervals in 1983. A third revision of fares was undertaken, and a new intermodal travel card season ticket was launched covering 5 new numbered zones, representing an overall cut in prices of around 25%. The one-day travel card was launched in 1984 and on weekdays was only sold for travel after 0930-1984-2000. London Regional Transport main article. London Regional Transport. London Regional Transport was the transport authority from 29 June 1984 to 2 July 2000. The GLC was abolished in 1986 with responsibility for public transport removed 2 years earlier in 1984. The new authority, London Regional Transport LRT, again came under direct state control, reporting to the Secretary of State for Transport. The London Regional Transport Act contained provision for setting up subsidiary companies to run the underground and bus services, and in 1985 London Underground Limited LUL, a wholly owned subsidiary of London Regional Transport, was set up to manage the tube network. In 1988 10 individual line business units were created to manage the network. London Buses Limited was constituted to progress the privatisation of London bus services. London Transport was converted to a route operating contract tendering authority, and the former bus operating interests and assets of London Transport were split into 12 business units under the banner London Buses. The 12 units competed for contracts with private operators from 1984, and were all sold off by 1,994/5 becoming private operators themselves. Further amendments to the fare system were made during this period, including inclusion of the separately managed British Rail services in January 1985. The Capital Card season ticket was launched, offering validity on British Rail as well as London Underground and London Buses. It was priced around 10-15% higher than the Travel Card. In June 1986 the one-day Capital Card was launched. The Capital Card brand ended in January 1989 when the Travel Card gained validity on British Rail. In January 1991 Zone 5 was split to create a new Zone 6. The Docklands Light Railway was opened on 31 August 1987 and was included in the Zonal Travel Card ticketing scheme 2000 onwards. Transport for London main article. Transport for London. Transport for London branding uses the roundel as a continuation of the London Transport brand style. The Greater London Authority, a replacement authority for the GLC, was set up in 2000 with a transport executive called Transport for London TfL that took control from 3 July 2000. It is the first London Transport Authority since 1933 not to be commonly called London Transport. The London Underground did not pass to TfL until after a private finance initiative PFI agreement for maintenance was completed in 2003. See also list of heads of public transport authorities in London. Transport in London references notes. Day 2000 a new fares contract for London. VE Transport in London Companies and Organisations Transport for London Airline Buses East London Transit Night Buses Coach Station Cycle Hire Dial A Ride London Rail Docklands Light Railway London Overground TfL Rail Tramlink Crossrail Under Construction London River Services London Streets London Underground Night Tube Source London Taxi and Private Hire Office Bus Operators Abellio Arriva London CT Plus Go Ahead London London Sovereign London United Metrobus Metroline Quality Line Stagecoach London Tower Transit Uno River Operators Bateau London City Cruises Crown River Cruises Live its launches Lower Thames and Medway Passenger Boat Company Thames Clippers Thames Executive Charters Thames River Services Westminster Passenger Services Association Train Operators Arriva Rail London C2C Caledonian Sleeper Chiltern Railways East Midlands Trains Eurostar Govia Thameslink Railway Gatwick Express Great Northern Southern Thameslink Grand Central Great Western Railway Greater Anglia Stansted Express Heathrow Connect Heathrow Express Hull Trains London Midland South West Trains Southeastern TfL Rail Virgin Trains West Coast Virgin Trains East Coast Other Global Infrastructure Partners Heathrow Airport Holdings Port of London Authority Airports within London City Heathrow Private, Biggin Hill Damons Hall London Heliport Military, Northolt outside London Gatwick Luton Southend Stansted Major Stations Central Area Bank, Monument Baker Street Blackfriars Bond Street Cannon Street Charing Cross City Thameslink Euston Farringdon Fenchurch Street King's Cross Liverpool Street London Bridge Marylebone Moorgate Oxford Circus Paddington Street, Pancras International Tottenham Court Road Vauxhall Victoria Waterloo Waterloo East Westminster Other Barking Bromley South Canary Wharf Clapham Junction Ealing Broadway East, Croydon Finsbury Park Heathrow Stations Highbury. Former, M41 West Cross Route A40M Westway A102M East Cross Route Ring Roads London Inner Ring Road London Ringways North Circular Road South Circular Road Charging Congestion Charge Low Emission Zone Ticketing Freedom Pass Oyster Card Travel Card Other History of Public Transport Authorities London Transport Museum Port of London Regent's Canal Cycle Routes Thameslink Trams Trolleybuses Windsor House Former Bridge Sectors Network Southeast Intercity British Rail Category Commons Wikiproject